So I just did Pharaby's nails. I want to talk about a few things that I feel like have made it easier for me over the years of having, I've had several dogs and cats and I've always used Dremel on them. So I want to tell you guys some tips that I feel like have made it easier for me to actually trim their nails over the years. So first off, if you have a grooming table, utilize that. So I always use the waist strap thing to keep her from sitting for doing her back nails. And then I always strap her, whatever, it's loose. Whenever I say I strap her to it, it's not like she's like, you know, really tight in here. But I always keep it so she can't turn her body because she wants to touch the Dremel. But you can probably figure out ways to like restrict them in certain ways, you know, so they can't hurt themselves. The other thing I do, if you notice, I have her tail, wrapped with a baby headband, and this is super, super stretchy. Like, it is not tight at all. Like, it's way, way stretchy, and it's kind of like a, I don't know, like a crochet almost looking thing. But what I do that for is her tail hair is much longer than her actual tail. You can feel her tail ends like right here, and then also she just has all this fluff. So I just kind of wrap that around to keep the fluffy end part wrapped in. So if you do that, just make sure you go all the way to the tip of their real tail before you start bending up. So that's what that's about. Obviously, if you have a short hair dog or cat, then there's no reason for that. I don't advise doing that with a cat because they'll probably scratch the crap out of you for it. And the last thing is her happy hoodie. And a happy hoodie, I'll link these below for you guys. But what it is, it's actually, it's like a compression sleeve type thing that goes over their ears. You can use this whenever you use your high velocity dryer if you're a person with a long haired dog. It's also good for like stuff if they're afraid of loud sounds like fireworks. But for us, she does not like to have her nails done. So it's just kind of a sense of comfort. Like, she can't hear it because the Dremel, it's not too loud, but you know, it's a little bit loud. It's loud like a drill, I guess. And then whenever you combine that with actually touching her hands and her toes, she's not a fan. So I'll link a happy hoodie for you guys, but you can use this, like I said, whenever you're drying their hair. If you have a long haired dog, it's also really great because it keeps their ears out of the way whenever you're filing their nails, because you don't want to get this ear hair in the Dremel because it'll pull it really, really hard. The Dremel I have is just the 7300. I've had this one, I've had this particular one for probably 10 years. I had one before for probably about 10 years. They last a while. They're not super expensive. But then the other thing I do, the other thing that's gonna make your life super easy is I use a 60 grit sanding bit. At first, that's like super, super rough. So obviously if your dog is, I'd say if your dog is less than 25 pounds, you don't wanna use a 60 grit. You need to go down a little. But I use this to get the bulk of the length off that I'm trying to get off of there for the day. And then I go over with, I don't know what this one is, but it's like super fine. It's like, it almost doesn't feel like sandpaper. It's so fine. But I use that afterwards to smooth it out so it's not rough on the edges. Also, if you're using a Dremel, you need to cover your face and you need to cover your eyes. So I just use, you could use sunglasses, whatever you have. We all have face masks now. But this is the one I use. I just use a bandana. I keep it in her caboodle, so I always have it. And then I just use safety goggles, but you could use sunglasses and a face mask, whatever you want. So she doesn't like her nails done particularly, and she also doesn't like her feet shaved. So I let her not have her feet shaved really, and I just file her nails and that's it. But she's not a fan of those things, so I feel like no reason to force her with the nail, I mean with the foot shaven, but we have to force the nail shaven. So I have the Dremel 7300. I'll have it linked below for you guys. And then you can get these six sanding bands. This is a 60 grit. I'm not sure what grit this one is, but it's, like I said, it's super fine. I don't know if you can tell, but it's like really fine.